YouTube, so long time no see, even though no one really knows who I am. But if you hadn't noticed, I used to make videos like 2 years ago when I was in senior high school, and then I stopped, and now I'm a sophomore, my second year, well, I just ended my sophomore year of college, and now I decided that I really want to do this again, because it's always been in the back of my mind, and when I go to sleep, you know, I'm like, God, maybe I should start making YouTube videos. And I wasn't big or anything. I mean, not saying like that. But I actually really enjoy just talking to myself in front of a camera. So, that sounds really narcissistic. I was just kidding, by the way. But on to my review that I want to do today. I wanted to do a review on the John Frieda Sheer Blonde Go Lighter. Spray. And yes, if you guys are familiar with this, or if you guys are watching this because you're thinking about buying this and such, you probably will see other YouTube people saying that this is only meant for blondes, and the bottle even says for blondes only. I hope you can read that. I don't know if my camera focuses because I use a flip camera to film my videos. But it says for blondes only, and obviously you can tell I'm not a blonde. Long story short, a friend of mine who also has really dark hair used this for a whole summer, I believe, and when she came back, her hair was so light brown, enhanced her features, I think. I think her brown hair really suits her really well, and I've always wanted lighter brown hair because I tend to have, like, I've always had just like jet black hair, because I am Japanese. So Asians don't really get like brown hair most of the time. They just get like black hair. And I feel like lighter hair tends to make my eyes look a lot more brown, because I have also really dark brown eyes. You can't even see my pupil because my iris color is just really dark. So I decided that I wanted to try this out too. The price, I believe I paid around $11 for this at CVS. I have seen this at Walmart for a little bit cheaper. I want to say like maybe $8. So if I were you, if you want to try this, I would recommend going out and getting this at Walmart, unless there's like a sale for John Frieda at CVS. And also, this review is only going to be meant for like brunettes, because I don't have blonde hair. I've never had naturally blonde hair, so I don't really know the lighting effects of this on blonde hair, even though it's meant for blonde hair. This is how it reacted with my hair, and I've been using this since December 2012. So it's been about 6 months. So I've used this for a good amount, and so I've used quite a good amount of this. I've used probably have that much left, and it really does work. It makes my hair, okay, granted, I think my hair is a little bit more orangey, but if you can see, hopefully, this is my second time filming this video, so I will put some clips of my previous attempt making this video, because I did it during the daytime. It's like natural lighting, so you can see how brassy actually my hair turned. Okay, what I do is I spray it all over my hair and I flat iron it, and it did damage my hair. Like, can you see how dead that is? Like, it's drier. My hair's already pretty coarse and thick. I don't know if you have seen my Ojon review. It says I did it a day ago, but I did it like 2 years ago when I was a senior in high school, and I basically talked a little bit about my hair, and it's just like really thick and really coarse, most of it, and now it's really thick and really damaged. But I must say, I love the effect of my hair now. It's like, what is my hair like? It's this brown color, and it's kind of on the orangey side, yes, it is a little orangey, but parts of my hair are getting a little bit like, no, yeah, it's just brown. Sometimes in the light, I feel like it's getting a little blonde, but I really like this. A lot of people are concerned about like using it a brunette and turning orange. It will kind of turn your hair orangey, but not like if you purposely dyed your hair orange. It'll really just turn it this nice brown color, and the more you keep using it, the actually blonder and kind of sandy brown. My only issue with it is that, okay, so I told you guys I only sprayed on tops, but then if you check like down here, it's still really dark, like up here and stuff. Let's see, my hair's not that long, but it's really dark, and there's parts of my hair when I just move it, it only looks like literally just the top layers are light, or like a lighter color, and the rest is like black. So if I would recommend using this, I would recommend actually spraying on the top layers and then actually sectioning off your hair and spraying it down here, which I've started using, doing it recently. Now, it took a while for me to get this color from a dark black. I try to only use this like once a week because it will damage your hair. It's hydrogen peroxide. It's gonna damage your hair. And my hair is really damaged, but I've been doing a couple things to, you know, help with the damagedness, and it's been working out for me a little bit. But I don't know. So basically, if you want light hair and don't care about damaging your hair, then I say this stuff is for you, because that's like me. I just really want a light hair, because you do touch your hair when you straighten it. I do recommend actually washing your hands off, because it kind of made my hands really dry if I didn't wash my hands off. But once I washed my hands off, my hands were fine. I think the hydrogen peroxide kind of just dries out your hands a little. But I love it. I probably will buy another bottle because I want my hair to be really nice and light for the summer. It is pretty light. I'll go into close up. My roots are still getting kind of dark. But my hair naturally is like this black color. Like, I'm not sure. I hope this is like showing up my natural hair. But now it's like this brown. It's really pretty and it's really light down here. So this is the kind of hair color you want. I really recommend it. And if you're like pretty, you have pretty dark, thick hair, this is probably what you're gonna get. And this is summertime, so lighter hair is a little bit more in now. So I just really do like it. It does turn your hair a little bit orangey. But let's see if you can see. Do you see, like, it does actually give me highlights. Like, my hair isn't all like one solid like brown. It's like there's like streaks of brown, there's like different types of brown and such in my hair. That's like all I really want to say about this product. I really do recommend it. Even if you are a brunette, I think you can still use this. I mean, it's not illegal or anything not to use it. It's just depending on the type of blonde you want. If you want, this will take you a long time if you're trying to go like from my hair color, like a dark, a black, pretty like a little bit brown, to a like platinum blonde. I would recommend just going out and buying some bauxite. But if you just want your hair to look that sun-kissed natural coloring, I do recommend this because it's more of a gradual thing. I'm too scared actually lighten my hair with like bleach and actually put straight up bleach on my hair because I'm afraid of how it's gonna turn out. But with this, it's just like a gradual thing, and it came out really nice. So yeah, that's my review. I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.